probably heard Trump's accusers call him a Nazi. Ridiculous. On the other hand, filmmaker Dinesh D'Souza calls many of the president's critics the true Nazis of today. Welcome to Wait Till You Hear This. I'm Steve Eastman.
I like the correlation where they talked about Nazism to what's happening in the United States and that Antifa are really the real fascists.
That's the reaction of one moviegoer I talked with after the show. Death of a Nation begins with gritty scenes of the last days of the Third Reich. For a moment, it made me wonder, which nation's death was the film talking about? And you may ask, what does the death of Hitler's Germany have to do with the dangers we currently face in the U.S.? According to D'Souza and the experts he talks with,
who are the real fascists?
Both Mussolini and Hitler set up and ran welfare states.
This was done by the do-gooders, the liberals, the people who wanted to improve society.
Here we go. D'Souza unearths a fact that Hitler admired the way Andrew Jackson, a leading Democrat who became the 7th president of the United States, treated American Indians. In fact, the filmmaker, who's a naturalized American from the country of India, says Jackson's approach served as a Führer's model of how to handle Poles and other Eastern Europeans. D'Souza moves on to consider the euthanasia movement in early 20th century America. It seems progressive Democrats outdid Hitler until he overtook them. Remember his killing of the mentally handicapped? It was legal murder without the consent of child or parents, so you really can't call it euthanasia. But that was the politically correct term the Nazis used. Now, let's consider how the movie viewed the history of slavery. It was pretty much a party line issue. Democratic politicians, even in the North, supported the existence of involuntary servitude in the South. Now get this. D'Souza argues American slavery inspired Hitler's use of concentration camps. You know, free labor. It seems some supporters even considered slavery as cradle-to-grave care for the welfare of blacks. What an obnoxious excuse from the self-serving elite. Moving past the World War II era, the movie concludes that progressives had to distance themselves from the Nazis. But D'Souza still finds plenty of examples of Hitler's policies being promoted today under 21st century names. Now you need to know this. D'Souza packs the film with plenty of documentation and promises more on the movie's website, deathofanation.com. At one point, the filmmaker says Republicans need to get behind Trump. That's the closest D'Souza comes to admitting there are also progressives in the Republican Party. I think they call them rhinos. I wouldn't do justice to this review if I left out an inspiring piece of history dramatized in Death of a Nation. Sophie Scholl was a 21-year-old German girl who wrote anti-Hitler tracts. She left them in public places, including open car windows and phone booths. If Sophie were alive today, she'd probably be blogging on the internet. Anyway, when a Nazi interrogator asked if losing her life for the cause was worth it, the young Christian replied,
"An end in terror is preferable to a terror with no end."
That sound you just heard was the blade of a guillotine, ending Sophie's life. So what's the takeaway from the movie? America must learn from the mistakes of World War II Germany. It's not too late to turn things around. This is Steve Eastman for Wait Till You Hear This.
Discover more stories like this one on our website, waittillyouhearthis.com.